Now, thanks for staying with us. Now, what's appealing about most work from home opportunities? Is it the sitting in the home with your hours, or lack of office politics, or working in your pajamas, or is it, I mean, it's really up to you. The lure of the couch, binge watching TV series on Netflix can sometimes seem infinitely more compelling than just about anything having to do with work. So no matter your work ethics, you're bound to feel unmotivated and sometimes distracted while working from home. It happens to the best of us. Now, not to worry, because we have experts here with us, and they will share some practical methods to help us optimize our time at home. Now, Bumi Wabweze leads the reward function for South, East, West, and Central Africa, as well as reward strategy for IBM Global Technology Services, spanning over 20 countries across the Middle East and African region. She's a human resource leader with over 12 years experience in different facets of HR, particularly within the high-tech industry. Bumi has led several HR projects leveraging on artificial intelligence and analytics, and she has a postgraduate degree in human resource management from the University of Bath, UK. She is a certified design thinking and agile professional, a member of the CIPD and World at Work. Now, remember, you can join this conversation. Tweet at us at +TVAfrica or at WeShowAfrica1 with the hashtag Waze, or you send us an SMS or WhatsApp to 081-803-84663. Thank you so much for joining us, Bumi.
Thank you, Uwa. Thank you, guys.
How are you doing, Bumi?
Now, I'm doing very well.
Thank you.
I'm getting used to the new world.
Yeah. Yeah, but this world is not so new for you, because when we read your profile, we had the conversation. You have been working from home for 9 years. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Okay. So I've been very fortunate to work for, two organizations. The second one, the organization that I work for currently now, have that flexibility to actually work from home. I have worked from home for the last 9 years, not permanently, in and out. There are times that I've worked from home for like a full month. Other times I've worked from home for 2-3 weeks. Typically, my working hours is quite flexible, and then I have 2 or 3 days that I normally would work from home. So I'm not really a full-time office kind of person. So in between the whole week, I'm either working from home or I'm working from the office. So I'm kind of used to the new ways of working now. So I'm very much used to it.
So if you were to access the lockdown, period, working, almost like full time now, what would be the difference that you have experienced? Because right now, then it's different. Probably children will be in school and all of that. But now everybody's at home, So would you say that is a convenient way, to go about your work, and you are effective and productive at that work?
I mean, for me, nothing has really changed. Like you said, what has changed is the fact that my children are actually at home with me now. I also have my kids having to do virtual online classes. So that's what has changed, really, essentially. And then, obviously, you have more people using the data connection, right? So you have more people on it now. So sometimes connectivity could be a bit slower, right? So that's the only change for me. Nothing has changed from the type of work that I do, in terms of me being productive, in terms of me being able to actually achieve the goals that I've set for myself. So nothing has changed from that, nothing much. Yeah.
Absolutely. Okay, Bumi, so for someone who's always worked from home, who's worked from home for a very long time, what do you think the fundamental requirements are for an organization, to have in place to ensure that there's an effective work from home culture? In terms of policies, infrastructure, what are your suggestions or your thoughts?
I mean, it's not going to be not an easy thing for organizations to do, because like the climate that we're in now, it's not a very common practice to see employers, having their employees work from home. It's not very common. But for an employer to actually start doing that now, the first thing is they need to invest in technology, I mean, that's not, it's not rocket science. You need to be able to invest in technology. You need to invest in collaborative tools. If you don't want your employees, you know, coming into the office physically, they need to have a way to collaborate virtually. So obviously that's from an angle of, you know, investing in tools. And then you need to provide basic tools of, you know, trade or tools of work, as you would call it. So if you're an organization that typically you would give your employees a desktop, you need at this point to give them a laptop, you know, because normally they can't carry a desktop home. So those basic tools, you know, you need that. You need to provide data, right? So if you're providing data, the bundles, or you're providing some sort of allowance to your employees to actually buy the data themselves, because the expectation is I can't fund working from home myself. I can fund the angle of, you know, providing electricity. This is my home, providing water, you know, stuff like that. But from an angle of, you know, data that I need to use to work, to do my office work, the company has to provide that. So that is standard. And then I know some companies that are used to this culture of working from home, they provide things like headsets. You know, when you mentioned distractions, I know companies that are actually providing noise canceling headphones. So you can't actually hear what's going on outside if you're on a call, so that you're not distracted. So from that basic tool perspective, you need to provide a laptop, you need to provide data to your employees. And then the company itself, they need to invest in technology, like I said. They need to get collaborative tools. So if you have Skype for Business, you know, this is how we're communicating. If you need to get on a video call on a meeting with someone, it has to be done through some sort of technology. If it's not Skype, it could be Slack, it could be Microsoft Teams. There's so many of them out there. So technology is number one, is key.
Okay, so Bumi, I like what you said about distractions. So personal, what's it called? Imposed distractions, where people are supposed to be working and instead of working, they are just lazing around the couch and binge watching different TV series, you know, and all of that. So how do we approach employees, you know, changing the mindset in terms of ensuring that they are disciplined working from home?
Yeah,
you know, they instill that discipline in themselves.
So that's what I was
saying. So it's a cultural thing, right? It will take a while. For employees that are not used to working from home, it will take a while for them to get used to the fact that I can actually produce the same type of output at home, you know, even though I'm not in the office, right? So there's really not, as far as I'm concerned, the only thing that is different is the fact that you're not in a physical office. Everything that you can do in the office, you can actually do at home, right? You have a routine. Normally, you would have a routine in the office. You would maybe come into work 8 a.m. and then you have your meetings. Those are things that you can replicate at home. So first and foremost, you need to have a routine. You need to assume that you're actually, you know, in an office, you know. You can do that by having a very nice, you know, office space in your house. I know some people that actually work from their beds, you know, and it works well for them. And I know people that need like an actual physical table and a chair to actually work from. So you get that sense that, you know, you're still in an office environment, right? So it's a mental shift, right? You just have to, it will take some time. If you're not used to it, it will take you some time to get, you know, acclimatized to the fact that I'm not in an office. But like I said, nothing changes, right? So a routine is very key. And then there has to be some level of integrity, you know. The fact that you're at home, I've seen different posts online, people saying, oh, now that you're working from home, it's an opportunity for you to invest in learning. There are a lot of webinars for you to attend. That is not actually the time for you to do that, because you're supposed to be working from home. So if your normal working hours is 8 to 5, you should be doing 8 to 5 and not using 3 hours in the morning to attend some webinar that is not related to, you know, what you're doing and all that. And then you have to try as much as possible to put in timeouts. So if you're not used to working from home, you don't have to take like your break at once. You can take like mini chunks of, you know, breaks. I can do 5 minutes and then I quickly go downstairs. I have a quick call, maybe with my parents, or I have a quick chat with my son, another 5-10 minutes. So you can do that so that it doesn't look like a stretch for you, like you're having to sit down in one place without actually moving, right? So that's the flexibility that you have when you work from home. You can spread your break into tiny chunks so that you can, you know, just sort of breathe and, you know, so it's really different for people that are not used to doing this, right? So it would take some time, But like I said, a routine is very important. And then as much as possible, you have to look for a way to get distractions out of the way. So for example, if you're used to putting WhatsApp on your computer, now is not the time to do that. So if you have WhatsApp web on your laptop and you're working at the same time and then the pings start coming in, you know, I'm having to quickly chat on WhatsApp and then I'm having to quickly type, you know, an email. So it's just avoid that temptation of putting WhatsApp web on your... Yeah, can you hear me?
Yeah, I can hear you. I just wanted to interrupt you very quickly. So from what you've described, right, it sounds like all that responsibility lies with the employee, which is fair. And, you know, assuming that we were all, you know, ethical and professional. But the employer wants to have a sense of control as well, and which is why I had asked about policies. So what kind of HR policies could you have in place to foster this sort of behavior? So if there are consequences for certain behaviors, or are there like timekeeping sheets? I don't know. You know, what can you put in place as an employer to make sure you drive that right behavior as well?
But you know, the thing with working from home is it requires a lot of trust, you know, from the employer to the employee, because it's difficult in an ideal setup. It's difficult to start, you know, sort of tracking time. I mean, employers can actually do that. Right now, you have employers that have time tracking tools where you come in, you log in, or you have, you know, some sort of tool that is a contact tool, like, you know, we have in my office at the same time, and then you know when I actually log in and log out. So employers can do that. But in an ideal setup, it's a trust. It's a kind of relationship that, you know, leverages on trust, right? And I think employers also need to be focused on the output, right? It's not the fact that I'm actually spending 10 hours working. That's what, you know, brings in that performance. It's the output employers should be looking out for. You can have people that are supposedly working, they've logged in, there's a time tracking tool, then, you know, in that tool for what, 9 hours, and at the end of the day, what they're churning out is not what you expected, right? So it's the output that really matters, you know. So that's what I think. But if you have employers that want to put in a time tracking tool, that's fine. You can also have check-ins, you know, like a checkpoint meeting with your managers, you know, just to know that your employees are on track with what they're supposed to do on a weekly basis. So it could be on a Monday morning, you have a 1 hour weekly checkpoint with all your team members, you run through all, you know, the activities for each of them, the goals for each of them. And then maybe at the end of the week on a Friday, you do another quick checkpoint, you know, just to check where they are. And then in between the week, because I mean, the goal is not to micromanage. Micromanaging never really works at the end of the day, right? So it's just to build that level of trust, you know, between yourself and your employer, and then between yourself and your manager, just ensuring that, you know, you're saying to them that I actually believe that you're working. And this is the expectation, you know, from you. This is me checking up on you on a Tuesday, on a Wednesday. Let's have a quick 30 minutes call to check where we are. You know, so a frequent, you know, checking up with them virtually would work.
Bumi, sorry to interrupt you. That is a situation where it's the ideal thing, where the employer is actually, you know, the employer is, what's the word now? That's the ideal situation. Nigerian employers, they want to see, I think they encourage mediocrity a lot. You understand? They encourage, let us be seen to be working, right? And if we already have that mindset that I want to my boss to see that I'm working, how would this play out? So in terms of if, for instance, we continue to do the work from home and you were saying focus on output, not the timing and all of that, with the kinds of mindset that some employers have, CEOs have, that they want to see their employers, they want to know that, yes, they are working, how would this play out in terms of remuneration? How would this play out in terms of promotions? How would this play out in terms of, you know, just generally the progress of the employer within the organization?
To be honest with you, because you know, there are different things, like I said, employers can do to ensure that the employees are working. They have tracking tools. They have, you know, you have to log in when you come in the morning. You know, there are a lot of those things, but like I said, for me, I still believe it's the output. There's so much that you can actually do as an employee to show that you're working, right? Do I have to sort of post somewhere that I'm working? You know, there's so little that you can do, but it's the output essentially for me.
I understand it's the output. So what I'm saying is now that I'm working from home, would that mean that, okay, since I'm not coming to the office, are you going to cut down my pay? Because it seems like maybe the work is less or something. Because some people are complaining, right? I was speaking with some teachers and they're complaining that, come, they're working like twice as much as they would have worked if they were in school. They would prefer to work, you know? So I'm just saying that how do you now measure that this person is actually putting in that work? You know, apart from all of the timing and all of that, so would there be compensations? Would there be promotions and all of that that would happen even within that working from home? So even if I'm putting all my time there, I know that yes, it's going to be worthwhile at the end of the day.
Yeah, I mean the thing with working from home, there's this. I mean, I think people, it's, like I said, it's a cultural thing, and it will take some time to change. A lot of people will think that the fact that you work from home, it means that your job is not relevant or your job is not critical. Like I said, I work in an high-tech industry. We have a lot of our developers, a lot of our engineers working from home. They're churning out results for different clients across the world. I have rolled out global projects sitting in my bedroom. So it's going to take a lot of learning. A lot of, you know, just changing the way that we think, right, to get, you know, Nigerian employees to that level, right? And then when you work from home, what I've realized is you actually tend to work longer hours at the end of the day if you're not able to manage and get yourself into a routine, right? Some people would work up until 9, until 10, and then you just think, oh, it's just, I'm in the house, I'll switch off my laptop for a few hours and then I come back, and then you tend to work longer. But essentially, it is the output. You know, there are certain roles that you can easily measure whether that person is working or not. For example, your customer care people, a lot of them are working from home. That one is easy. You can track the number of calls they've answered if they were to be in the office and then they're at home. Maybe they've answered less calls. You know, those sort of work, it's much easier for you to track that kind of work, right? But there are certain jobs that you feel you might not be able to track as an employer, but like I still maintain it is the output. Nothing changes. I'm having meetings with my clients. My clients too are not physically in the office. I have to have the same meetings with them virtually. You know, things are progressing. So that's why I said collaborative tools is the key. That's when you know whether your employees are working or not. We have tools that are project management tools, for example. There's a tool called Trello. In Trello, different people can log in at multiple times. You're expected to log in what you're doing on a daily basis. For example, I met the client today. I've just submitted an RFP. You know, so yeah, there's a way you can track if your employees are working when you invest in technology. That's the only way you can track it.
Okay, Bumi. Right. So you've just spoken to, you know, some people can work from home. And a question I had was, do you think there are particular industries or roles that are more amenable to working from home? Or do you think that everybody can actually work from home? That's one question. The second thing is, with the industry that you work in, so Facebook, for instance, came out to declare that they're going to, they're now planning to start working from home permanently going forward. And that's on the back of the productivity they've seen during the pandemic from people working from home, which they, you know, had concerns about prior to the pandemic, right? So an objective way, as you said, is to see the productivity and see if people are actually doing the work, the output, right? So, are there particular, is it because it's technology, is it easier for these sort of industries to do work from home, or it's across board?
I mean, it's definitely not across the board. There's certain roles. Imagine if our nurses and doctors were working from home. So
they
it's
are.
Certainly not all
roles, we're doing, right? We're doing teleconsults.
I had a
teleconsulting. I had to talk to my doctor on the phone. They prescribed medication. You know, I know it's not perfect, but...
But I mean, the ones that actually need to be, I mean, if you know, my point is, yeah, imagine if every nurse or doctor was working from home. I need people that you actually need to attend to. So certain roles, it's not best practice. It's not the best thing, right? But there are lots of roles. Trust me, by the time we're done with this lockdown, a lot of companies would actually realize that maybe 60 to 70% of their employees can actually do the work they do from home, right? And then obviously you don't need that much office space, you know, you're going to, you know, downplay in terms of cost for your leasing and all that, right? So certain roles, if it's not a client-facing role for me, when I say client-facing, like an external client-facing role, you don't necessarily need to be in the office. If you're in back office, even sellers, even if you're a seller, you're a marketing person, you don't need to necessarily
come
work
to the
from
office,
the
yes.
office and work from home, because you know that's where we have virtual conferencing and all that. So it's not, but I think quite a huge percentage of employees and certain job roles can actually work from home. That's what I believe.
So
with
but,
technology.
Thank you so much, Mumi, for your time. Ah, we were talking and we just ran out of time. Wow, so we have to take a short break. Oh, thank you so much, Mumi, for joining us this evening. We'll take a short break and Amuche Chidozie will join us right after. Please stay with us.